Come up here. leave work and come here, it's almost 3 hours. You're
supposed to play with him.
I left. Oh yeah, this week, hell week. We shut down twice a year for the 4th and Christmas, and we got inventory. And inventory. Well, I mean, you know, multi-million-dollar company has a lot of product. And my plant was one of the 6 plants that we operate. And they all want to talk about the food. They're tight on inventory now, which I'm good. I'm happy about that because I get a bonus being the plant manager. I get a bonus in a year. Part of my bonus is based on the percentage of my salary. So that's big, that is what it is. The other part of my bonus is based on my plant profit. So overhead, you know, overtime, and, you know, there I look for you leave the room, turn the light off. You know, we had a water leak here a couple weeks ago. I got on there, but I'm like, you need to get maintenance over here and fix this water leak. Our water bill's going up. So anything I can save money on means my plant makes more, but my bonus is bigger. I work for Craftmaster. I'm a plant manager over Plant 3.
Our boys ain't good hustle. Our
that was the right place at the right time. Well, my company, I was with a company called Kellett Seeding, and they closed our factory in Morgan, and I got laid off, and I was production manager. And I was happy with it. I liked the people working for me and everything. And I really hated the job, but they didn't offer me a position. And so I was out of work. That was in August. I was out of work in September and October. Well, I had 2 interviews in that kind of track manager, and they hired me to be their production manager at Plant 6. It was only 20 minutes from home. So I jumped all over that, and that was about an $8,000 a year raise from what I was making at Kellett. So I thought, hey, you know, it worked out good. I'm still close to home, making money, you know, but I took it. Well, we were supposed to go back. It was off the week of Christmas, we were supposed to go back the day it came out in the first year. Well, that was when I got COVID. And I was sick, so I called in the first morning we were supposed to go back to work. I called in with COVID. About 3 hours later, the vice president of manufacturing called. And I thought, because I had been there since November, I thought he was going to call. So he called me and he said, I got a problem. I need to know if you're willing to help me with it. I said, what problem might that be? He said, my plant manager went through, didn't come back. Well, that guy named Steve Stigman had been plant manager there for 25 years. And he retired. And they had another guy that was running to take his place named Paul Miller. Paul came back there for it. He called in and said he found another job while he was off for Christmas. So they didn't have plant manager. And I hadn't been, I've been in the company less than 2 months. And they all said, plant manager. And I called him. To take the plant manager job. So now I'm making $20,000 a year when I was making Kellett. I thought, well, yeah, good Lord, barely looked out for me. And so I took that. And I thought about it. You know, I've been a production manager, but I've never been a plant manager. I mean, so I never had that kind of authority, that kind of position. So I was a little nervous about it. And
that's one.
Most plant managers, you know, that's a job to work your whole career for. Most plant managers are late seasons.
Not one.
Seasons, that's a job that you might be in 8 or 10 years and you need to come with.
How do we play?
Have that position 45 and hurt. So I turned this down. I may take it 10 or 12 years before I get a I said, I got my chance. If they took me in there and they told me what my salary would be, $4,000 would be more than I was making. $1,000 more than I was making. And I was, you know, and I didn't want to go up and hug the man. I'm like, well, you know, it sounds pretty good. You know, I'm
the whole time.
Yeah. I'm trying not to jump out of my skin, and I'm playing it cool. But yeah, you know, let me think about it over the weekend, and you know, and he's like, well, I got my money more. And I said, oh, well, yeah, I think you know, that's good. And he said, how far are you driving to the Northland? I said, 20 minutes. He said, how far the drive would be to Plant 3? I said, about 40 minutes. And he said, well, you double your drive. $3,000 a year in gas for last. I said, do I have to wait till 1 in the morning to let you know? He kind of smiled. He said, I thought so. So, my God, yeah, so on top of the $1,200, they give me $3,000 a year for gas. Because I doubled my drive. You know, it's a little bit of a pain. I got to number up to be 5:30. Take Charlie to the house like a 6. My plan opens at 7 when I come. I'm normally there between 6:30 and 7. So, this is getting up early these days. I pull 12 hours, but you know, it is what it is.
Yeah, I got a fighter.
And I told him about it. Physical labor, I got it. I said, but it was nice to punch the clock, go in and do your job, worry about making your money and feeding your family and go home. Now I go in and I got to worry about how that lady feeds her family and how this guy feeds his family. I got 116 people working on me. And I had one come in my office about a month ago because I got her department on full time.
Thank you. Go!
around the corner. One, two, got to beat.
No time.
Come on, what's up? Keep it going. I'm going around. Let's go. Hey, get it back to Rich. Let's go.
Wearing you out back here. Boy, Santa Phil's got a cannon. That boy's got an arm.
I'm talking about shoot.
That thing curved right to you.
Oh, boy! Oh, boy! Oh, boy!
Take it.
I don't
fire, baby. Keep it fire, baby. Okay, keep it fire, baby. You okay? Keep it fire. Come on right here. Line off. Keep it in line, bro. Line off. Keep it in line back here. Come on. That a boy. Move right here, baby. Come on now. Move along right there. Let's go, 12. Move along right here, baby. Will, be running. Be running, baby. Here we go. Be running. Two out. Be running. Now he's going to be on your ass.
Oh, yeah, that cut in.
Varsity, you mean, baby.
Go! Come on, baby.
Gotta be fair.
Yes,
Yeah.
sir.
Seven support, I mean the people that keeps holding down the fort. Yeah, they got your back, that's a fact indeed, 'cause you can text them anytime, they got the answers.